Hello and welcome. Today I am going to share with you this. This is the world's cheapest French horn. The instrument itself comes from China, as you would expect, and it has the Muse Lady brand laser engraved or etched onto the surface of the bell. This French horn is remarkable in that it is incredibly cheap. Relatively speaking, French horns aren't cheap, but this one is only between 150 and 170 US dollars. It is remarkable what you get for that money. It is a functioning instrument. The valves work fine. All I had to do was put a little bit of valve oil down the tuning slide and they work perfectly. It has a removable bell, which makes transportation in its case a whole lot easier. I did have to put some grease on the threads of this. Otherwise, the sound of metal scraping on metal when you unscrew this kind of sounds like the death agonies of a pterodactyl. But other than that, it's remarkable. It's remarkable. The instrument itself is in the key of B flat. Now that's something to note because if you are aware, most French horns are in the key of F, and French horn music is also tending to be in the key of F. So when you come with a B flat French horn, you're going to find that the fingering is going to be different. So if you're a trumpet player and you're thinking about going and learning the French horn, if you pick up a B flat French horn, your fingering schema is going to be different to what you're used to on a trumpet. As far as the design is concerned, it has mechanical linkages for the valves. We also have a black sort of pretend leather cover for the grip where you put your hands, just to protect the finish on the brass, which is nice. It doesn't have any spit valves or water keys on it, so if you get water in it, then you're going to either be removing all the tuning slides to try and find it, or else rotating the instrument end over end 150 times to get the water out. But that's not uncommon for French horns to have no water keys. And so I guess the question is, what is the sacrifice that you make to get an instrument as cheap as this? Well, it doesn't appear to be the build quality. The build quality is obviously made down to a price point, but I've got nothing at all to complain about with this instrument. There are a few blemishes and imperfections here, but really, for a student-grade instrument, I've got no complaints whatsoever. What you do appear to sacrifice, though, is the tone quality. If you go onto YouTube and listen to the sound of a good French horn player, they're going to be playing usually on an F instrument, but you compare that to the sound that this instrument makes, and you can immediately tell that you're playing a cheaper grade of instrument. For a student or a beginner or somebody that just wants to experiment or meddle, it's not going to be a problem whatsoever. The instrument doesn't sound rancid. It's just not as good a tone as you would get from a more expensive instrument. And frankly, in my opinion, given that the reason that this instrument exists is for students and for learners and things, I have no issues with that sacrifice whatsoever. So if you're interested in learning more about this particular instrument, there is a link to the TomTop website in the video description below. They sent me this instrument free of charge in the hope that I would review it and say nice things about it. They haven't paid me to say nice things specifically, so I am giving you my honest opinion based on the evidence that I have in my hands. So I hope that you've found this video enjoyable and informative. Thank you very much for watching.